This short presentation is brought to you by the University of Hawaii's College of Tropical Agriculture and Human Resources. Let's begin with some background information about the olive fruit fly. Bactrocera olei, order Diptera, family Tephrididae. The olive fruit fly is the most important olive pest, not just in the state of Hawaii, but across the entire globe. It was first seen in Hawaii in 2019 on both Maui and Hawaii, and is widespread in olive groves on both islands. What does an olive fruit fly look like? The head, thorax, and abdomen are light brown with darker markings and several white or yellow patches on the top and sides of the thorax. Olive fruit flies have black spots on their wingtips. Only one egg is laid per fruit, but sometimes multiple eggs may be laid in large olive fruit varieties. Larvae are yellowish-white, legless, with pointed heads. In what ways can an olive fruit fly cause damage? Adult females deposit eggs into ripening olive fruit. The larvae feed inside the fruit, destroying the pulp and allowing the entry of secondary bacteria and fungi that rot the olive. Feeding damage can cause premature fruit drop and reduce fruit quality for both table olives and olive oil production. This pest can cause crop losses of 100% of some table cultivars and up to 80% of olive value. Next, we'll look at a tool we can use to monitor a fruit fly population. What you see here is a McPhail-type trap that is used to monitor olive fruit flies. We need to place 3 tablets of Torula yeast lure in 300 milliliters of water. This will attract olive fruit flies that we can trap and then count, giving us a better understanding of the size of our fruit fly population. The trap should be placed in the tree about 4 or 6 feet high from the ground. At least 4 traps per acre will suffice to monitor olive fruit flies. You should check the traps weekly to ensure the water hasn't evaporated, but usually you will need to replace the Torula mix every 2 weeks. Several companies sell McPhail type traps, and you should contact your local extension office for a source. However, if McPhail traps are not available, you can make your own, as seen here on the left. A McPhail trap can help you monitor your efforts as you reduce the population of fruit flies at your farm. But it won't actually do the killing for you. Instead, consider GF120NF Naturalite Fruit Fly Bait. The person applying the GF120 is required to wear coveralls, waterproof gloves, and shoes. It's an organic bait product containing the biologically produced insecticide spinosad. It keeps fruit fly populations in check by attracting adult flies to feed on the bait, which is then killed due to the spinosad. GF120 is a concentrated product and needs to be diluted with water before application. GF120 should be applied at 3 to 5 ounce dilute spray per tree using a 1 to 1.5 dilution or at a 5 to 15 ounce dilute spray per tree. Using GF120 with bait stations prolongs its effectiveness. You can create your own bait station using a plant pot saucer and other off-the-shelf equipment. Regardless of what you use, it should be a spray painted yellow in order to attract flies. Depending on the abundance of the fly, you might need anywhere from 8 to 12 bait stations per acre. GF120 applications should begin when olive fruit fly adults show up in the McPhail traps, or at least 2 to 3 weeks before pit hardening. Repeat applications every 7 days while flies are captured in McPhail traps until harvest. GF120 can be purchased from a local agricultural supplier.